This church, and thank you for tuning in online and while we worship.
Thank you. thing. I know you said your power went out again. If you ever, I have power here in town. You need anything. You need to come to Bondi, anything.
We have so much.
Call me. Put it in front of me. You just, you come. You bring the family.
I mean,
I've got laundry facilities.
I don't know about you, but
I just don't ever.
The Lord has spared my life.
Please,
this week.
Just know my house is open.
When I ran my car or Leisha's car through that electrical line and that tree in the middle of the road, and should have been dead. I could crawl out the back, got out. It was the grace of God.
Yes,
I know that my house is okay.
Yes.
Your houses are okay.
That's right.
You know, we've learned that we can be little house on the prairie.
So true.
We can go to the river like Brother Michael and get some water. Hallelujah. We are Americans. We are ingenuitive. There you go. We can survive anything. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Turn with me to Matthew chapter 14. Verse number 22, I want to thank the Lord for what he's doing in Sister Barbara's life. He's brought her from the point of death.
Oh, yeah.
Literally death.
Glory.
And
amen.
She is walking and in a regular room now and heading in the direction towards going to a rehab. And she's got a little ways to go yet, but I thank the Lord for what he's doing in her life. How he's taking care of the rest of us. Praise the Lord. There's a song that a black quartet used to sing years ago. Jesus will pick you up if he has to reach way down.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but there's been some times that he's had to pick me up out of the miry clay and put my feet on the rock to stay. There's been times where my heart has been overwhelmed and I do what the scripture says in the book of Psalms, that I run to the rock that's higher than I. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Matthew 14:22 says, immediately Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side. Notice he made them. Now they're about to go into a storm. And he made them go through it.
That's right.
There are times when the Lord will make you go through difficult days.
Yes.
The death of a loved one. The loss of a car. The loss of a home, the loss of power, the loss of the luxuries that we enjoy so much. And Jesus made them go in the boat alone. Do you ever feel like God has gone on vacation and left you alone? And left you to fend for yourself? I'm here to tell you the word is always true, where he said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. You may not feel that he's right there, but he is always right there. When I'm at my lowest point mentally, emotionally, spiritually, materially, financially, he is always there to pick me up out of the horrible situation and set my feet on level ground. Verse 23, when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. And when evening came, he was alone there. Now remember, the disciples are still out there on the boat fixing to face the worst storm they've ever faced.
Mm-hmm.
That they don't know how to deal with on their own. Jesus is not there. He's up in the mountain praying. I'm going to tell you right now, Jesus is standing at the Father's right hand right now, interceding for you and
that's
for
right.
me. And He was interceding
right.
for them in the boat before the storm ever started.
That's right. Yes.
And so He knew before Helena got here to Waycross, He knew He was interceding for you and for me. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Praise God. Now, verse 24. But the boat was now in the middle of the sea, tossed by the waves, for the wind was contrary. Have you seen some contrary wind lately? I tell you, Alicia and I had to drive to get the tag off her car. They hauled it over, Allstate hauled it over to Tifton. Thank you. And on our way to Tifton, you will be lucky to see one or two trees standing.
Wow.
From here to Tifton, it's like Tornado City just went through and just flattened trees up by the roots laying.
Wow.
Sheds laying across yards, and I think to myself, oh my Lord, those poor people. I had two ladies come over yesterday to get some clothes because they didn't have any clothes. All their stuff was ruined, and so they called and said, I saw on Facebook the ad that your church gives away clothes. And I said, yeah, I'm here at the church, come on. And so they came, and they live in Pearson, and their whole city is just about, you know, flattened down, just so much devastation. But here the disciples are in trouble, and they're in the middle of a place they can't get out of. You ever been in a place you can't get out of? Your mind is locked into unforgiveness. Your mind is locked into hatred. Your mind is locked into to just worry and fear and doubt and discouragement and every other emotion. And your finances are locked and you can't go to an ATM because there's no power and they don't work. And you can't get food because all the grocery stores are closed. And you can't do anything because the power went out and your food's all gone. And you just don't know what you're going to do. Sometimes we get into the middle of the lake. And you can't go nowhere. You're stuck, but you're not stuck because Jesus is there.
Thank you.
Jesus knows when to show up.
That's right. When
you're stuck. Hallelujah. The Bible says in verse 25, now in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them walking on the sea. Now here's the problem. The sea, the wind and the waves and the everything just going crazy around the boat. And Jesus is just walking on like it ain't nothing. He's just walking on it. And everything that you've had to face and that you're about to face, you can walk on it because Jesus has already shown us how to do it. He came in this flesh, in this life, so He could show us how to live in flesh.
Come on.
He was all God, but He was all flesh. And so when He was walking on the water, He wasn't walking on the water as God. He was walking on the water in flesh, filled with God.
Amen.
Yes. When you get filled with the Holy Ghost, you can handle anything. If you yield to it.
Yes.
You got to yield to the Spirit of the living God so He can walk through you.
Yes.
And use you to help other people. Proverbs 18:24 says there's a friend that sticks closer than a brother. That's Jesus. Hebrews 13:5 says, let your conduct be without covetousness. Be content with such things as you have, for he said himself, I will never leave you nor forsake you. That's a promise you can go to the bank with. That is a promise that even E.F. Hutton can't make. That is a promise that you can hold to with everything within you, that God is not going to fail you. I don't know about you, but I've done some stupid stuff. You ever done some stupid stuff?
Too many,
Dan. We don't want to all go there, do we? We all got that award when we wear the hat with the star on that says, I've done stupid stuff. Wear the t-shirt. I've done stupid stuff. But even when I am in the middle of the lake, in the middle of the sea, Jesus knows how, he knows where I'm at.
That's right.
And he comes
yes.
to me. He comes to me. And he comes to you. It can be 3 o'clock in the morning and you can't sleep. And the Lord will come
yes.
to you. I can't tell you, I was out in the yard just crying my eyeballs out. I was just crying to the Lord and thanking him for things that he helped me with and strength that he gave me that I just absolutely did not have, but he gave me the strength to do certain things. Mm-hmm. And I was just crying and saying, Lord, thank you. Daddy showed me certain things. He didn't even intend to show it to me, but he showed me, you know. And I'm so thankful, and I was just sitting there crying. I just throwed my hands up to the Lord right there in the yard, and all of a sudden, the Spirit of the Living God in the middle of a Thursday or Friday afternoon just fell on me and gave me his supernatural touch and his supernatural strength to help me through a very difficult moment of just sorrow and grief and pain and struggling. He knows what you're going through. Jesus understands every need that you have. He understands every emotion that you can experience. There is no temptation taking you but such as is common to man, but God will, with the temptation, also make a way Amen. Of escape.
Amen.
And there is no, no problem that you have ever faced or will face in the future that my God has not already faced. And Jesus can turn over to the Father and say, Lord, I have, Father, I've been there when I was on earth and I experienced the same thing and I passed the test. Now, Lord, give Randy the strength to pass the same test. So here comes Jesus walking on the sea. The waves are over their head, but they're under his feet. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Matthew 14:26 says, and when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled. Sometimes our miracles look like trouble. Sometimes, LaDonna was telling me yesterday about one of her friends that she went up and handed a homeless guy a bottle of water or something, you know, and he whipped out in his pocket a wad of money and he's offered to pay her, and she said, I don't want your money. And he said, I got $3.8 million in the bank. I'm homeless by choice. And I'm thinking, Lord, let me meet that homeless man.
That's right.
My name is Jimmy. I'll take all you'll give me. But it was just, you know, you just never know who's going to bless you. You never know that your worst enemy might bless you.
That's right.
You never know that the person that couldn't stand you, but now they're blessing you.
That's right.
Yeah. God's presence sometimes is scary to some people. I've been in church services where the power of God fell and the whole church was slain of the Spirit at one time. And I've been in services where people shouted and jumped and screamed and folks got a little nervous. You know? But I'm here to tell you, Jesus ain't never nervous.
Amen.
He ain't never scared. He ain't never upset. I've had to, from the pulpit, sometimes say, you know, what meaneth this? And explain it. So folks didn't, you know, run out the door. Because I remember when I first walked into Pentecost and stuff happened, you know, it scared me. And it drew me, but it scared me. And I couldn't leave, but I was scared. You know, but we don't know how God is going to provide.
That's right.
And He surprises us every time. And we think to ourselves, now, how is this going to happen? How is this going to be? Verse 27, but immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid. Sometimes that strange person that comes up to you at the store is Jesus.
That's right.
Sometimes that weirdo walking down the road is Jesus. He says that we entertain angels unaware.
That's right.
Sometimes He sends provisions and things through people that we had no clue.
That's right. Amen.
Where they came out of or why they even. I was at the high school the other day because the girls had a volleyball thing, and their coach, they made a bunch of wonderful, wonderful pork chops and all kind of mess that went with it, potato salad and green beans, and it was G-O-O-D. It was good. And then when I started to leave, she said to me, she says, now I want you to go grab some of those cans and some of those things over there. And I grabbed all I could get. I grabbed and grabbed and grabbed because I knew I was going to meet people that needed stuff. You know, and so I grabbed all I could grab. And so you just never know where provision. I didn't even want to go to that volleyball game. I didn't want to sit on that bleacher with no back and hurt my back. I had no intentions of wanting to stay. And then when I got there, I was the only parent that showed up. And I said to the girls, I'm sorry, I'm leaving. I feel weird being the only parent sitting here, you know. So I went to the nursing home and visited some of the folks that was over there. But when I got back, I got blessed.
Amen.
Got blessed. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Jesus is saying to you this morning, be of good cheer.
Yes.
That means be happy. Be happy. I know we could be those folks up in western North Carolina.
Amen.
We could be underwater. Our whole city could be flooded out. Men hanging out of trees. All kinds of horrible things has happened to those folks. We just had a little wind damage and a little power outage. There's no water for a little while. But you know what? We made it.
Amen.
We made it.
That's right.
Hallelujah. So we need to be happy. We have every reason in the world today to be happy. We can breathe.
Yeah.
We can walk.
Yes.
We can talk. We can use our hands and our feet.
Yes.
We have so much to be thankful for. Hallelujah. Verse 28, he said, and Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water. Now, he uses two words that do not go together, Lord and if. Those two words do not mix like oil and water. Because the Lord is not about if. He's about doing.
That's right.
And all Peter had to say is, Lord, just let me come out there to you. And the Lord said, come on, just like you did. But he said, Lord, if it's you. How many times do we question whether this is God? I'm here to tell you that the Bible never lies. He says, all things work together for good to those who love the Lord and to those who are called according to his purpose. And every bad thing that happens to me or you is for our good and his glory. And we have to accept that. And we have to say, yes, Lord, I'm looking for the good that's coming out of it. We need to be more like Job that said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. We need to be more like the three Hebrews who said, our God is able to deliver us, but if not, we're still going to serve the Lord.
Right.
Isaiah 55:9 says, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways and my thoughts, your thoughts. My little pea brain up here can reason all day long, and I can envision and imagine things, and I can say, well, Lord, it would work out good if you did it this way, or if you did it that way. And the Lord's like, my ways are higher than your ways, and what I've got planned for you is more than you can even think. So Jesus, he just told Peter, come on out. And Peter got out of the boat. And for just a minute or two, he walked on the water. What an awesome experience to get to walk on the water. To walk on your problems. The thing that scared you so bad. The thing that worried you so much. You're walking on it now. And you're just walking on it. You know what? We're supposed to tread upon serpents and scorpions. And over all the power of the devil. There is nothing that the devil can throw at you that you're not supposed to walk all over it. And when the devil is saying, you're defeated, I say, no, you're under my feet. So Peter's walking on the water, but all of a sudden he starts looking at the circumstances more than he's looking at God. And that's my failure. That's your failure. That's all of our failure. When we start looking at the stuff that we're going through more than we're looking at the supplier of our need. My supplier is not Georgia Power. My supplier is not FEMA. My supplier is not Lowe's. They're out of everything that I need. But my supplier is not Kroger or Walmart. My supplier is not the government. My supplier, his name is Jesus Christ. He is my source. He is my strength. He is my supplier. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But poor Peter, he gets like Randy, and he doubts, and he falls under the water. And he's gloop, 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 gloop. When I was a kid, we used to sing that song, Anime. Where are you going? Upstairs to take a bath. Anime with legs like toothpicks, a neck like a giraffe. Anime fills up the bathtub. Anime pulls out the plug. Oh my goodness, oh my soul, there goes Anime down that hole. Anime, Anime. Boop, boop, boop. Well, that was Peter. He went down the hole. He was Anime. He went down. And he went so far down that Jesus had to reach his hand down and grab a hold of his hand. And he pulled him up out of the water. He's just baptized again. He's soaking wet. His hair's in his eyes. Can you imagine? He's like an old wet dog. I mean, he is just sopping wet. And Jesus has picked him up in the middle of his mess.
That's right.
And he walks him back to the boat until Peter steps his foot over into solid wood. And he is standing in the boat saying, "Thank you, Lord, for reaching your hand down and pulling me out of that mess and putting me back on a solid foundation."
Yes, amen.
If you're going through a struggle today, realize that Jesus has not forsaken you.
That's right.
Jesus is right there with you. He's going to be with you when you go through the dark night. He's going to be with you when you're alone. He's going to be there when you feel like everybody and the pastor and the world and the government and everybody else has forsaken you. He is going to help you through your struggles.
That's right.
We used to sing the song, "Reach out and touch the Lord as he passes by. You'll find he's not too busy to hear your heart's cry. He is passing by this moment your needs to supply. Just reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by." He's here right now to meet your need. Will you pray with me? Father, in the mighty, wonderful name, Jesus, I ask you to touch every person in this house, every person watching by way of internet that's been going through stuff, that's still going through stuff, that's about to go through more stuff. I pray, Father, that you'll put your hand on them and pull them up and put them back on a place of sure foundation. Forgive us for doubting and having unbelief. Forgive us, Lord, where we have failed to trust you, to just not look at you as the author and the finisher of our faith. But Lord, we've allowed ourselves, like Peter, to look at the circumstances. Forgive us. Forgive us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you for watching by way of internet.